Hello everyone, this is Randy here again. Another episode of Farming Simulator 15, and we are playing on the Bjornholm map again. I was going to do the MIG map, then so, I kind of felt like doing some logging again. So we're playing on the Bjornholm map. Where, like I said, we're going to do some logging. Now as you can see, I got some more money again. I did go ahead and sell the last bit of wood. That was that one pile we had over there, so we need to cut some more down here. And what I did to sell that pile, or to actually to load it, I should say, not necessarily to sell it. I sold it the same way I always do. Drop it in the pond. No, let me set that a little bit longer. Like 8 meters. There we go, much better. Sort of. There. I used the telehandler there to load the trailer. That went pretty good. And I know last episode, I couldn't remember what I didn't like about it. It wasn't until I got in it that I was like, oh yeah, I know. I remember what I don't like about it. And they have fixed that with a recent update. So, where do I have the telehandler? Actually, it's right over here. Let's hop over there a minute. And if you guys recall, I was saying something about last episode. I didn't like this thing for a particular reason. Couldn't remember then what it was, but what I didn't like was the fact these controls were separate. You actually had to switch between the log grabber and the telehandler itself to actually operate the different controls. Now you can actually be on the log grabber itself and operate all the controls, so you don't have to sit here switching between them every time you want to change something. So that works much better now. That was the main reason I did not like it before. And yeah, it just made it really difficult to use, switching between your implement every time. So they have fixed that with the update, so no longer does that. And as you can see, we started a base all the way by that large hill slash mountain over there. And we're all the way over to the road here, so we've definitely decimated this forestry area. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna cut down a couple logs here in a minute, then we'll start loading them up. And we may give the front loader a try. I've got a couple ideas about that. See if we can make work what I was thinking I want to do with it. That must have been a short tree. Hold 3 pieces off that one. What we'll do, we'll cut down these, what is there, 1, 2, 5 trees here, and we'll start loading them up. Off screen there, I already cut down probably another, there's probably 5, half dozen or so there. And these logs that are laying here, by the way, have fallen out of the trailer. They've been laying there for a while now. I should probably come through and pick them up or do something with them or something. Just haven't done that yet. I'm going to have to check if I got traffic turned off or something, because I have not seen a whole lot of traffic coming down this road while I've been logging. I know in the past I've dropped some logs on the road, and there'll be a nice big old backup of cars lined up behind it. I've not seen that with the logs I have here, so I'm not sure if it's turned off. I believe that is an option they added with the recent update. And if it is off, I did not turn it off. It must come that way then. Actually, is it in the options here? And now it must be in the game options itself. Okay, that's fine. said, I'll have to just double check that and see what it says about that, because I can't say I've seen any traffic lately. At least not out this way, anyway. And other news, Farming Sim 15 is going to be releasing a steering wheel here eventually. I'm not sure exactly when it's coming out. I seen this the other day. They are partnering with, I think it was Mad Cats, their keyboard. Those who have seen that, that thing is ridiculous. Yes, I believe it's going to be a steering wheel, and then it's going to include an extra side console for like front loader controls and other stuff as well. I forget all the stuff they listed it was going to have, but sounds pretty cool. So I'm not exactly sure when that's going to be coming out, but I may want to cut a couple of those trees down as well. They might get in the way there. Looks like these last two remaining ones are kind of small. We'll just cut this one up right here. Sure, why not? Nice flat area for doing them in, that's for sure. And I was thinking, too, we do have the money at the moment. We may look at picking up a wood chipper here, too. We'll see how far we get here. Just see how bad everybody says it is. Okay, we'll just knock down one or two of these trees over here, too. Looks like they might get in a little bit of the way. They're kind of closely stacked here. Probably should have watched that a little more. Nope, that's probably a little too close. And if you can't tell, I'm kind of trying to keep this stack a little bit more closely stacked together. Figure the front loader, when we pick it up with that, that'll probably be a little more ideal that way than keeping them spread apart like I normally would with the crane. Just knock this one down here too while we're here. Back up a little more yet. Now, I did have one log that kind of glitched out on me. Wasn't really anything wrong with the log itself. It wasn't a ghost piece or nothing, but something about the log and this Ponzi scorpion here, it did not like. It was just throwing this thing all over the place. I'm not sure what its issue was, really, but... didn't like something. I don't know what. Only had one like that. That was the only one I had. Everything else has been good so far. Okay, you seriously can't cut that in my, oh, I'm not quite lined up as I thought it was. Okay. There we go. Okay, we'll just do that one more tree here, then we'll have this kind of whole... Whoa. Okay, must hit that one there. Then we'll have this whole area done, kind of, sort of. That'll just leave some trees down in there. Not a whole lot of trees there. Like maybe... it's like maybe 30 trees left, I'm going to say. I should look. I wonder if there's a counter somewhere that's actually counting how many trees I've cut down. I would like to know, because it sure seems like I've cut down a lot. I know there's a bale counter, but I'm not aware that there's a log. Ooh. Don't we like here? Kind of a messy log pile here. I was hoping to try to keep it a little bit straighter, but oh well. We'll see how this goes. Got a couple little miscellaneous pieces laying around here and there. Yep, that's what I was thinking about getting the chopper for. And we got a piece here, there's a piece there, and I think there's a couple more pieces out that way, too. There's one down there. Big piece up here. Now, I don't think the chopper will get this piece, I don't think. I don't know, I could be wrong on that. From what I've seen other people do, they've really struggled with it, especially with the bigger pieces. So, let's grab the truck here. Crafter's Bind was saying he'll have a happy bah humbug then. If that's what you want to have, that's okay. Like someone lost a lot of little logs there. Oh, where shall we park this thing? It don't look too bad here, I guess. Probably won't hurt if I grind that stump out first, but I think we'll leave it there for now. Crafters might also ask where I got the winter theme. And I believe... Pinkanels, I think is how you say his name. Actually, no, I don't want this one. Responded with a link to that. Yeah, it's Bjornholm map. Winter edition. Let's see, can you make it up this little, well, maybe not quite so little hill? Ooh, make it, yeah. Okay. Now, I have used this thing, like I said, a little bit before. And was totally unimpressed by it, so we're gonna try this again. Yeah, this part is here is kind of what unimpresses me. Let's see if I tilt this forward. Nope. Not quite. Ah, we'll just we'll grab those three then. Yeah, it doesn't seem to grab real good. Now, maybe I'm just not using this right. I don't know, but... And then if it isn't full, then they kind of rock around in there. It just doesn't work real well, in my opinion. Probably good if you can get a full load in there, but yeah, I definitely don't have a full load, so... And then to top it off, it really doesn't lift high enough, especially if you got them not in there real good like I do. Obviously is not a very good place to have this thing, is it? Okay. That is as high as I can go. We roll it in there. Come on, there. Okay, perfect. We got it in yet. Ideally, I'd like to have them a little bit closer to the front, but the way I picked them up, that didn't really work. But I think the best bet, let's actually park this on the road. I don't see any traffic anyway, so I don't think they'll mind. Okay, we'll call that good. Hopefully, anyway, for the moment. As you can see, it does obviously work nice. I loaded two logs there. Not the greatest, mind you, but I did get two logs loaded. The part I don't like is, one, it doesn't really lift high enough. Especially if you don't have them in there good. And then to actually grab them, it doesn't seem to... Like I said, I may be doing something wrong. Maybe you guys maybe I should watch some more videos of people doing this, even if I got some better techniques and stuff, but getting those actually in here is like difficult. So drag them out here. There we go. It's like this thing needs to close a little bit farther and clamp on them better and hold them tighter. That's unfortunately all the better it gets them, so I'm pretty sure that one piece is going to fall out. And at the very least, I as... Boy... No way I'm going to get that in there if it doesn't straighten out, is it? That's the whole problem I find with this thing. Yeah, unfortunately, if it just clamped a little tighter, it probably would have it. Or if I had more logs in there, obviously that would help too, but... yeah, I'm not sure. Now, I was watching Dirt Tabbers. He kind of had an interesting thing. I think he was at... Was he using the telehandler or front loader? I don't remember what he was using again. He had this front loader... And then he was filling it. I don't recall what he was using to fill it with again. If it was the telehandler or a tractor with a front loader on it. But I thought that was a rather interesting idea. There we go. Straighten out a little bit. This piece here. Yeah, there's no way I'm going to pick that up with this thing. That's a joke. See if we get a couple more on here in a minute. Okay, we got those two. But yeah, they're gonna be... Oh, this will be fun to load. Okay, maybe we'll grab the telehandler after this then, because the telehandler actually was going pretty good. I think I loaded it faster with a crane yet, but the telehandler went okay. But the telehandler definitely grabs onto him a lot tighter, and kind of prevents this annoying bit that's happening there where they're hanging out. And you just see if we can get you out of there. Yeah, kind of, sort of. J.E. Tedgemeyer was saying, every time I try to run the Direwolf new Direwolf 20 pack, when it starts to generate the world, the game shuts down, and he says, yet he can still play the old pack just fine. Yeah, I don't have an answer for you on that one. I'm not a Minecraft tech expert. Yeah, a couple possibilities come to mind. Possibly your computer isn't powerful enough to play it. I know the new Direwolf 20 pack definitely a lot more resource intensive. That is for sure. So that could be a possibility. Also, another possibility too, with all Minecraft related stuff, make sure you run the latest, greatest video card drivers, updates, especially update your Java. That is vitally important. If that don't do it too, you can always reinstall everything Minecraft related. That might help as well. As you can see, this thing grabs too. I'm a little bit too far that way. This thing grabs tight enough you can actually pick the log up without it kind of messing up, I guess you could say. Come on. Okay, let's see if we can get that one little bugger out of there. Now, yeah, it still don't grab these that good, because these are pretty small. Oh, we got it yet. Wonder if we can get it in the trailer now. Let's try. Normally when I go pick these up, and I did pick up a couple of these with this thing, I pick them up a little closer to the other... yeah, it's going to fall out. I'm just going to let it fall out too. Anyway, like I was saying, I pick them up a little closer to the other end. Gotta love the turning circle on this thing too. It's like really good. The only thing that still annoys me yet is this thing is obviously backwards, that opening and closing of the claw. Or at least it is, in my opinion, anyway. Go! Perfecto mento. I think that stump there is in the way. Yeah, this thing kind of actually has the same problem the front loader does. I'm probably not going to be able to reach it now even with the extendo feature. That claw tends to miss the piece on the end there. It's really hard to actually jab the forks underneath. I'm not sure. Can't just push on it. You know, real life, those forks would just kind of go underneath, you won't have to worry about it, but, yeah, that doesn't really happen in this game, unfortunately. So what you can do, and what I've been doing too, try to pick it up a little bit and tilt your forks back, and then hopefully it'll roll down onto your forks, and then you can pick it up nice and good-like. Okay, there we go. I think what we'll do, folks, like I said, I was thinking about getting a chopper. I think we'll do that in a minute. Let's go pick up the chopper. Let's see, under forestry. The Jens chopper, 88,000. Did that 250 horsepower. We better get a bigger tractor then. Let's see, which one of our tractors has that much? That's got 263. I know you guys have enough. Okay, thought the Dutes was open. We'll take the Dutes over there. 17 Burgers PC Minecraft is saying, have a Merry Christmas, Randy. And did you happen to see about the Giants are doing? So it should be a pretty cool hope. Yeah, should be pretty cool, hopefully. If it's not too costly. So I'm assuming you're talking about the steering wheel and console thingy that Giants will be releasing. It says he would like one, and he's getting two joysticks. I'm not sure you have to get a joystick, because supposedly, like I said, a little console thingy that's supposed to come with it is going to have a front loader control thingy on it, so I would assume that's going to be some type of joystick. I would assume, anyway. That's normally front loader controls are joystick operated, so... Vehicle shop, really? Did not know that. Oh, this thing must be heavy or something. What? To be honest, it does look rather heavy. I'm sure that chop up wood, it would have to be. Michael was saying on the multiplayer episode, don't see how I can stand all the lag in your multiplayer server. Said he would have given up a long time ago. Yeah, that was kind of annoying their last episode on the multiplayer server. Don't know what caused it, unfortunately. It was pretty good there, about 15-20 minutes in or so, it finally cleared up and was good. And it has been real good up until then, so... I think it's the server or the server host's fault. Probably my internet connection was acting up just a little bit, and yeah, don't take much for farming sim. Slightest problem with your internet. Oh, that's an interesting view. Wasn't expecting that one. Next view I switch to, and I see a fence coming up. Anyway, like I was saying, the slightest bit of problem, I mean, you're a little bit too far away from the server, and right away, yeah, it's game's up for you pretty much with farming sim. Okay, where do I have some of these pieces yet? Oh, that was a stump. That's a big stump. I want you to grind all these stumps out yet. See, I thought it... Ah, okay, there's the pieces. Okay, fold out support feet. Oh, that folds out the tray too. Okay. And turn it on. And pipe out. Yeah, we don't have a pipe. Yeah, we can leave it out, I guess. Do I have a trailer? Oh, I do have a trailer. Yeah, but I don't think it holds wood chips anymore. I don't think. I could be wrong on that, but... pretty sure when they took the collision out, that took out the grain plane as well, so Okay. Oh, you know what? This does have the camera view. Yeah, perfect. This, by the way, is what that one behind the tractor crane needs as well, that I have that mod. Oh, where is it here? Yes, this thing needs that. That's the one thing I don't like about that thing. Oop. A little higher, apparently. Should probably be a good crane for loading wood with. Okay, I'm kind of sort of sticking it in there. Let's move a little bit closer if we can. Interesting results there. Oh, crap. Now, it looks to me like I did chop a little bit off there, but I don't see any wood chips in there. I'm back here, you. Okay, what happened to my crane? Ah, there's my crane view. Yeah, I do rather like the crane view anytime I'm trying to load logs. I do find that to be... that's going to be an interesting grab. Yeah, like I said, a lot of people have found this thing to be less than optimal. Oh, again. It's very glitchy when it's moving. I don't know why. Doesn't move as smooth as I would. You know, the rest of the equipment seems to move relatively smooth, but this thing is like... Interesting. Okay, let's try grabbing the one on the over here then. And we'll... I probably can't even reach that one anymore, I don't think. This might be the, you know, one of the first and last times I use this thing. I don't know. Thought I'd at least give it a try. Like I said, I know most people say it's pretty much worthless because you can't use it, so... But wood chips are pretty good money if you can get them. Not sure how you're going to manage to get them with this finicky setup, but... Yeah, this thing does not move smoothly at all. Okay, let's see if we can get this one lined up a little better than we did the last one. That looks to be right down the center of the conveyor belt there to me. Kind of bounces around on it. That's weird. I wonder if I'd have to have a trailer here for it to actually get wood chips. I was hoping to actually just see it to work a little bit, just enough to know I was working. Now, if I let go of you, will you stay on that conveyor belt? Oh, you will. Hey, there we go. That's what I want to see. Apparently, I'm going to... Nope. Hey, that was chopping wood there. Okay. Didn't get any, obviously, because I don't have a trailer here. Anyway, I might have to mess around with that some more after this episode, see if I can get something to happen with this. And anyway, folks, then I think we better call it an episode there. You have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them below. And as always, thanks for watching, and until next time.